good evening, one and all present here. My present day, I will be talking about a course which is known as computational physics course, and this is a part of undergraduate physics BSc physics course in Himachal Pradesh University, and it is treated as a skill enhancement course. So we teach this course to second year students or third semester students. And my presentation or talk will be based upon, I will just take touch the spreadsheet and its features, because Ahluwalia sir has given us a complete overview, what is a spreadsheet, why we should use it in our sciences, and how is it different from the programming language like that. So you have an idea, complete idea about that. And I would like to talk about how we can enter data in our spreadsheet, how we can perform the mathematical task in spreadsheet, how we can insert charts and graphs if we have data in with us. And lastly, I'll take some exercises in spreadsheet, which I have done with my students of the skill enhancement course. So let me start with that. Like sir has also talked about that, in all the sciences, or especially in physics, we need an integration of experimental, theoretical, and computational physics. And for computational physics, I think for computational in physics, we know spreadsheet will be a very good instrument for us. So that's why I think in 2013, under RUSA, Himachal Pradesh University introduced computational physics as a skill enhancement course in UG physics curriculum. And what is there in this course? In this course, we are supposed to talk about the algorithms and flowchart, how to move ahead with the problem. Then we also talk about a scientific programming language, Fortran, that is formula translation language. The scientific word processing, LaTeX, is also taught to students so that they can write their, say, small projects or something like that in LaTeX instead of Word. And then finally, we talk about the electronic spreadsheets and how we can visualize the data with, which we have using electronic spreadsheet. There is another tool known as GNUplot also there in a syllabus. So these five components are there in the syllabus of skill enhancement course known as computational physics course. So I will be just touching the fourth part, that is introduction to electronic spreadsheet. And in this topic, what we are supposed to do with the students is that starting from the basic fundamental, what is spreadsheet, what is there in a spreadsheet, how we move ahead with the spreadsheet, students are supposed to do all these exercises, which are these are hands-on implementation of the problems. And I think most of you are familiar with this. Like we talk about mean, standard deviation, then Stirling formula. If you are a physics student or chemistry student, so these terms are very much familiar to you. Yesterday, Sir Ahluwalia sir has talked about the trajectory of a projectile, then quadratic equation. So all these things, all these exercises, students are supposed to do in this spreadsheet. And I think you can also take these exercises. Once this course is over, you can also try all these exercises in spreadsheet. Now, what is spreadsheet? I will just recapitulate the thing. The spreadsheet is an excellent tool of Microsoft Excel for teaching and learning mathematical model in physics. So it's as simple as that. It's an electronic spreadsheet, which is a tool for us to learn the mathematical model. And then why we should use spreadsheet? So why we are emphasizing on a spreadsheet? Why we, Kulvinder sir has taken this program for you. The reason is that in spreadsheet, no special coding language is required. Ahluwalia sir has already mentioned it very clearly yesterday. It has a simple and very accessible interface. So very user-friendly interface we have. Dynamic spreadsheet can help to learn how the graphs and charts are produced from the relationship of different variables. So I will take a few exercises with you. And how we can perform big calculations with the mathematical functions. This is also part of my talk. And how we can collect, organize data, compute statistics, and do error analysis. So the last part I will take tomorrow, the error analysis part, how we can go with error for error analysis in spreadsheet. So let me start. What we are supposed to do is to open Excel. I'm just recapitulating the thing. You have already know this by this time. You already know all these things actually, but just for our as a teacher, we are in a habit of recapitulating the thing before starting a new lecture. So to open Excel, we have to go to the Start button, then go to All Program, select this Microsoft Office Excel, and start your work. If you have an icon on your desktop, double press it, you will be in a spreadsheet. If you open a spreadsheet, you will see this page. And here in this page, this is known as an office button. This is known as menu bar. And I think, again, I will say that Ahluwalia sir has discussed all these menus yesterday very clearly to us. And this is important part of a spreadsheet, which is known as a cell. And the black boundary of this represents that this is an active cell. It means presently we are at this moment, we are here. So we are supposed to enter our data here where you find this box and highlighted one, the bold one. So this is known as active cell. This whole thing is known as worksheet. This is worksheet, which is made of number of cells. This is known as row. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. These are rows. And rows are denoted by numbers. One, two, three, four, number. And A, B, C, D are columns. And since we are in this cell, so its address is given here, which is written as A1. So column name comes first and then comes the row number. So A1 is the cell address. So we are presently in A1 cell. This is a snapshot. So in snapshot, A1 is our cell address. Then this is known as status bar, which tells us whether we are ready for the worksheet or not. And these are the sheet numbers. There are three. So by default in MS Excel, we have three worksheets and we can add more spreadsheets from here. So all these spreadsheets, when they are combined together, they become, this is known as workbook. So worksheet is a single sheet. And when you combine lots of sheet, it becomes a book, which is known as workbook. So this is for zooming and this is for view button. You can have different layouts. Now, let me go to this spreadsheet. I've talked about this cell, active cell. I've talked about the cell address. And I have talked about the column. This is row and this is worksheet. This is status bar and zoom. And in Excel spreadsheet, we have these many rows. Now number is big and 16,384 columns. And in 2007, Excel 2007, we have 1,024 worksheet. Maybe in 2010 version, we have more worksheet that you have to see. So many worksheets are there in a Excel spreadsheet. So you can have these many spreadsheet to work. Now, how to enter data in a spreadsheet? In a spreadsheet, we can enter the data in three ways. We can enter text, such as name of variables, titles, roll numbers. We can add numbers. We can add formula and functions and like this. Okay. So other thing which we can do with the data entry is we can edit the data, select the data, move data, and special symbol we can add. So let me take you to a spreadsheet and I will do all these things with you. So I will take a spreadsheet from here. Let me take this. Can you see this spreadsheet?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is a spreadsheet and if you see that presently it's showing C14, it means my active cell is this one, which is in a C column and 14th row. So this is the address given here. This is known as formula bar. Here I can enter a formula and I was talking about the data entry. So let me say that suppose this is, I've just done this exercise before, like I can add this much, I can add, sorry, 1 minute. I can add the name, age, marks, and then I can add the another column here, weight. suppose I want to add the weight of my class students or something like that. So I can add. Now you see that I have, I can enter the data in terms of alphabets. I can enter in terms of numbers. I can take both the things also. So there are three ways of entering the data. You can text it. You can enter it in the form of a text. You can enter it, suppose, in terms of number. So let me say I am substituting these values here. Random value I'm just putting. And so I have added the weight also. Okay. Like this. Now see that, suppose I have entered something wrong, I can edit it. Suppose this value is 67. I have entered 67, but it's not 67. It was 76. So I have to just click this cell. It will become active. Now you know the active cell. You can change the value. So it has become 76. So this is that you can actually edit the data in your spreadsheet. Like this. So this is the way of entering the data in the spreadsheet. The first column here, the first row, you can keep it for your titles, like name, or if you want to insert, suppose I have missed something, I can just click this and I will press the right part of my mouse and I will enter insert key. So I have inserted a row here. I have inserted an extra row. If I want to insert one more row, I will put one in more insert. So this way I can insert the rows also. I can delete the rows. Suppose I want to delete this row, I can delete this. So this can be done very easily. You just highlight or click your mouse on the row, active one, and just click the right side of your mouse, and you will get this drop down menu. From here you can do the inserting, you can delete the thing, you can clear the content. Suppose I want to clear this content, I don't need this thing, so I will just select it and press right, and then just say you want to clear the content. So you can format cell, you can clear content. So if I'll say clear content, this all thing will go. If I press Control Z, then everything I will get back. So these things you can easily do here. You can do one more thing. I was saying, inserting a comment. Yesterday you were talking about this part, inserting a comment. Now see that here, suppose I want to insert a comment, I will make this an active cell, press right side of mouse and write down insert comment. And now you can write anything. So I can write that this is the weight of class. I can give the name also, BSc first year. So this, now if I want that this comment should go, I will just and press the enter. But if I want that this comment should be there only, it should be like this. So I can show it. There comes a this option, show or hide comment. So if I press it show, it will remain there only. If I say show the comment, it will permanently remain. If I want to remove it, I will just say that hide this comment. So then this comment will be hidden. And this red triangle type of a sign shows me that there is a comment. Whenever I'll just click it, I'll get the comment here. So you can show it or you can hide this. You can copy this data, select it, again press it, and copy the data from here. You can copy it. And you can say you want to take it to this side, you can take it to this side. Paste it. So Control C and Control V are the option which we normally use. You can control and paste it. Again, if I don't want it here, I will press and clear content. I will take the do this. So this is a way we enter the data in a worksheet. We can add, we can make any and as much number of columns as we want. So up to this point, things are clear. Please respond.
Any doubt, students, if there is any doubt regarding this?
Otherwise, I will proceed further. Okay. Should I proceed then?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, you see that another thing which we normally do in the classroom or something like that, if you are entering your data, this feature is important. So, I'm not taking all the features, but the features which are important. See, this is another important feature. I have selected the name of the students and I'll just go here. And here, see, there is a, tab here. See, there is this editing tab. Here we can sort the data. Here we can sort the data. Sorting means I can write my data in terms of alphabetical order. So suppose I press A to Z, so it will write down the names in terms of A, B, C, D, E, like that. If I want Z to A, it will take V up. And then if I suppose I say that I want it from Z to A, then this V1 will come in the first position. So we can always sort the data. This is another feature in a spreadsheet. You can sort the data. You can filter the data. Filter the data means suppose we want to do some calculations, but I just want that I want a data in which the marks of the student should be above 10 or above 10 only. So I can select it again. I can select my data and I can sort and filter. I can filter the data. So I will select the marks and then I'll say filter it. And this is a sign for filtering. And for filter, here I have to put the filter. I say I just want the marks which are more than say 15 or 12 or something like that. So I will just take those marks. Rest of the things will go. So I will just take these marks and I will get this thing only. You select. If you want to select less than 15 or more than 15, you can do it. So this is another important feature when you do calculation in spreadsheet, the sort and filter and find and replace. This is I'll just take control Z and find and replace also. So find and replace also, this can be used. You can just go and see what is find and replace. You can say select something and you can replace it by some other thing. So this is the whole thing is a spreadsheet, three sheets by default. I can enter one more sheet here. Sheet number 4 has come. I can enter one more sheet. 5 will come, and this way we can add number of sheets and we can move from one sheet to another. So suppose in for sheet number 1, I have some data. In sheet number 2, I have some another data. Sheet number 3, I can keep some other data. So these are the important features of a spreadsheet which we make use in our calculations or something like that. So let me come back to my presentation. I'll take this spreadsheet side by side. Now, I have talked about how to enter data. So click on the cell, type your information and press enter. The data will be entered. Okay. You can edit the data. I have shown you how we can enter, edit the data, select the data. You can move the data, control C or control V or copy paste. You can move it, find and replace data and special symbols you can add. Okay. So that I'll take the references part I will take later on. So this I have also talked. You may want to organize or rearrange your data in the worksheet. So you can use sort and filter option. You can go from A to Z or Z to A. So first enter your data in the worksheet and then you sort it out. Okay, filtering of a data I have shown you. Filtering means that to pull out data from those rows and columns that meet some specific condition. Usko nikalna hai bahar jo hame chahiye. So the other rows or columns get hidden. So if I want the name of the students who have got marks above 50, then in my data, I will can use this filtering option. And I say filter that data. If I want that in my data, I want all the students whose age is more than 20 years, I can filter the data. So you can use this thing in spreadsheet very easily when you play with your data. The next task is how to add mathematics in your spreadsheet, how we can add mathematical things in the spreadsheet, which is important for us as a physics student or as a physics teacher. This is important. So the formula one, important thing is, then in our spreadsheet, we have a formula bar. So you know that I've shown you where was the formula bar. I will show you again where is the formula bar. We go to formula bar and just write down our formula. The only thing here to remember is that the formula always starts with the equal sign. So whenever you have to enter the formula, you have to put a equal sign first. Okay, I'll show you how to write a formula. And these are the operators which we use in spreadsheet for writing our formula or for doing the mathematics, the mathematical things and all. Addition, you are familiar with all these things. Addition, subtraction, multiplication is always written with the help of this asterisk. We don't use the cross sign. We use this star one, which is known as asterisk, and it is there in your computer. In my computer, it's on number 8 key is there. numeral 8, uske upar jo hai star, with the shift I will press that and this will be for multiplication. So even in Fortran for multiplication we make use of this. For division we use this slash, slash, and then exponent we use this caret sign. This is also there on a numeral 6. Above numeral 6, we have this caret sign. So with shift key, you can press it. You will get this caret sign. And then percentage sign. So these are the signs which we make use in spreadsheet. And then this you have to remember that order of precedence of operators. How they operate. Like we have BOD mass in our earlier classes. Here we have to remember this. Please excuse me, dear Aunt Sandy. Remember this sentence. So first, parenthesis will come, then exponent will come, then multiplication will come, division, and then addition and subtraction. So this way, this spreadsheet is going to take the operators. In this order, the operators will work. So starting with parenthesis, we will go to exponent, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. And to remember this thing, remember this sentence. Okay, so let me take you to the spreadsheet. I'll show you this spreadsheet only. This spreadsheet, this I have developed for measuring the diameter of a rod using screw gauge. So here we have, I have done something else also, deviation, square of deviation, etc. This part I'm going to take tomorrow for calculating the error. Today, I'll just talk about I have entered this diameter, how we can enter the formula. Okay, so let's go to spreadsheet again. So I will take this spreadsheet. Can you see this spreadsheet now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, good. So here, see that I have the first row. I have just put the title of what I am doing. I've just put the title, diameter of a rod using screw gauge. So you can make your spreadsheet more interesting, more interactive by decorating it. Decorating it doesn't mean that you have to put flowers and something else, but you can make it more attractive. I have not done much work on this. It's a simple one to show you how to enter the formula and like that. So this is diameter of a rod using screw gauge. I have taken this diameter of a rod using screw gauge, and I have taken these many readings. 10 readings I have taken. 102. These are the readings. Okay. So in centimeters, I have taken this readings. Now suppose I want to find out the mean. Now I'm just talking about the formula. How to enter a formula in a spreadsheet. So what we do, we put the data in our spreadsheet. Simply go to any column. I have started from column number B. You can start it from A also. You can start it from C also. It doesn't matter. Wherever you want to put, you can put. So normally, number one, this is left for serial number and like that. So serial number I can add and I can write down the readings here. So the diameter, first time I've got this reading, I entered it. Second time I've got this. So I have taken the 10 readings. So now what I do, suppose I want to find out the mean. So I have to select a coil. Suppose I have to find out, mean I selected this cell. And then what I have to do is I have to put here equal sign. This is known as formula bar. Okay, put the formula. For a formula, I have to put equal sign. I can write, if I want sum, suppose I want the sum of all the diameters. So I will write sum. These are known as functions. These are functions. If you can see this list, these are the functions. Sum, I don't need all these functions. I just need sum. It's inbuilt function in a spreadsheet. So when I type equal to sum, automatically it will come. Then I have to give the range. Range is this. So for this range, I say B. B, I'm taking the column. Okay, B column, B3. Now you see that when I type B3, this column gets highlighted. So it means my range is starting from this number. Okay, then for a range, I put a colon sign. It means from this number to last number, that is B12. That is B12. Now you see that when I selected the range, the spreadsheet has highlighted the whole column, which will come in my calculations. Okay, and then I say, close the this bracket and press the enter. Now you see that I've got the sum here. In row number 15, I've got the sum. So I can write here sum. So this is my sum of values. And this is mean. Suppose I don't write here mean. Now let me calculate the mean. So I say, I go to formula bar and I say put and average. Okay, so when I say AV, average comes here. I select it, average. Again, I will give the range B3 to B12. My data. This range can vary. Okay, I have 10 readings. You can have 4, 5, 6. You just have to give the range and press enter. You will get here the average. So mean I have written. So I have, this has calculated the average value. Okay, so this way, I can put another formula, different formula here. Okay, in this column, you see that I have written, if you look at the formula bar, it's showing me something equal to, then B3, it means the address I am giving it, B3. B3 means it has taken this value, 1.025, B3. Column B, row number 3 ka address, diye le rakha isne idhar, B3. So when I highlight a cell, it gives me the value which is sitting in this column. And minus of $B, $13. Now see that this is the thing which sir was talking about yesterday in his lecture. He was talking about the relative reference and the absolute reference. Okay, so this is actually known as absolute reference. It means that $B, $13 means that B13 pe jo value hai, that is fixed. So when I put anything with the dollar sign, it means that becomes a fixed value. So if you see this spreadsheet, in B13, mean value is sitting, average value. It means for my next column, what I want is that the average value, which is there in B13, it should remain the same. Okay, so that's why I fixed it. And if I go to the next column, you will see that the next column, the address has changed to B4, but the $B, $13 is coming as such. If I go to next column, it is coming as B5 minus $B, $13. So now you see that B5, when I go from one cell to another cell, the address of B is changing. It's becoming B3, B4, B5, B6. Automatically, it's changing. This is known as relative reference. Isko bolte hai relative reference. Jo automatically, when we go from one cell to another cell, then we don't have to change the formula. Wo apne aap us cell ka address change hota jata hai. So this is known as relative reference. And when you keep it fixed, ye jo ugly value jo humne fix kar rakhi hai, that is known as absolute reference. So sometimes we make use of all these things, which is known as mixed reference. Yes, sir.
Can you please zoom it?
Yeah, definitely, sir.
As dollar sign is not clearly visible.
No, it's fine, sir.
It is okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is actually the cell address which I'm talking about. B5, then if I go here, it's becoming B8. So it has taken the value of B8. And then this is, the mean value is fixed, always fixed. So this way, if you remember, this is the way we calculate the deviation from the mean value. So here I said that deviation from the mean value will be the value which is there in this column minus the mean value. So it has calculated this. Then what I don't have to put, I just have to drag it like this. Dragging means you put your cursor here and just press the, say, drag it. And it will automatically calculate the things. It will automatically calculate it. So here I have taken the square of deviation. So now you see that what formula I have used. I said equal to and C3 multiplied by C3. C3 means I have taken this value, C column, third row ki value, ko multiply kar hai aapas mein. I can write multiplication. I can even use the caret sign and put 2 square karke. Wo bhi main likh sakti hun. I can write it in two ways. So this, in this column, I have taken this multiplication. And I have to put a formula in one cell only. Aur baki ko sirf drag karna hai aur sari values apne aap aa jati hain, automatically aa jati hain ye values. Sirf formula humne ek mein dalna hai. Baki sab mein ye khud drag karenge, aap isko leke jaye cell ko highlight kare, yahan pe plus sign nahi dikhega, isko left ko mouse ka left ko press karke isko drag kare. You will, with practice, you will come to know. So I've calculated the square of deviation like this. So this is the way. So important thing to remember here is whenever you put a formula, always start with the equal sign. Otherwise, ye aapka nahi lega. Agar main isko equal sign nahi dungi, to ye formula nahi lagega aur ye aapka ye cheez calculate nahi hogi. Aapko clear ho gaya math ka formula hum kaise enter karenge? Isko bolte hain absolute reference kya hota hai, mixed reference kya hota hai. Ye terms clear hui hain aapko?
Ma'am,
can we proceed further, or do you have any question? So if you don't say anything, then I will proceed.
And we can proceed.
Okay, so this is so I'm coming back to my presentation. This I wanted to show you. I have taken the spreadsheet from snapshot from the same spreadsheet. So mean value kaise calculate kari aapko dikha diya, formula bar kya hai ye maine aapko bata diya. फॉर्मूला में इक्वल साइन लगाते हैं, ये आपका फंक्शन है. सो वी हैव टू टर्म्स हियर, फॉर्मूला एंड फंक्शन. ओके, सो दिस इज अ फंक्शन, एवरेज फंक्शन. ये बहुत सारे फंक्शन आपको स्प्रेडशीट में मिलेंगे डिफरेंट नाम से, अरिथमेटिक फंक्शन, स्टैटिस्टिकल फंक्शन, लॉगरिथमिक फंक्शन, ऐसे बहुत सारे फंक्शन आपको स्प्रेडशीट में मिल जाएंगे. सो दिस इज द सेम थिंग, स्नैपशॉट हाउ टू इंसर्ट द फंक्शन. हां जी,
इनफैक्ट यू नो when we are talking about these things,
Anji, sir,
which are called functions, these are the built-in functions in the spreadsheet.
Yes, yes.
In Excel, these are the built-in functions which we are using.
Yes, sir.
But you can have user-defined functions also.
Yes.
Which actually is possible via macros or via VBA. Built-in functions of the Excel itself.
Yes.
That's it. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. So I'll be talking about the built-in function, and sir, you will continue with that macros and VBA later on. Okay. So relative references which will change in relation to the new location of formula. I think you will appreciate it now. When we went to new location, B3 से B4 या B column address जब हमने change किया, so आपका reference change हो गया उसका formula में. After copying a formula containing relative cell addressing, the cell addresses are adjusted to reflect the new location. So by default, all cell references are relative. Put a absolute reference, dollar A, dollar ke saath mein aap isko absolute bana dein, then it will become a fixed one. And if you use all this together, this will be known as mixed reference, A, dollar 1 plus dollar B, 2, like this. The row of cell A1 is fixed, and the column of cell B2 is fixed. So if we have this type of adjustment, then this is known as mixed reference. So editing a spreadsheet, editing a spreadsheet, you can rename it, you can delete it, you can insert a new worksheet. Insert part I have already shown you. Like insert, you can delete the sheet from here. You can rename the sheet. It's written as sheet 1, sheet 2. You can give it your name, experiment's name, like that. So now let me come back to the lab part, actually, how we develop this spreadsheet. In labs, you know what we are supposed to do in the lab. So whenever we go to lab, we perform some experiment, and then we ask you to study the relationship between the different variables. So we take two variables, we study the relationship, and draw the graph. We understand the what is the thing, the type of what is the connection between these two variables, and like that. We do all these things in our lab. So main thing is we try to plot a graph. Suppose you, if you remember, even if I take a simple pendulum case, you try to plot a graph. If you take Hooke's law, you try to plot a graph. So graph is a very important part in our physics lab. So this can be, I mean, you can easily plot a graph in spreadsheet. So my next part is how to plot a graph in a spreadsheet. For this, you know, the left-hand side, I'm showing you a simple experiment. I've just taken a random experiment and a random value of this experiment. So this is actually an experiment where we study the relationship between weight added to a spring and the extension produced by this spring, which is also known as Hooke's law. So one, we keep on adding the weight here. If you remember, recall this experiment, you keep on adding the weight and you note down the extension. So we have two columns, one side weight, other side extension. So this table, if you have made it in your say notebook, we can take it to spreadsheet. So here I have giving you a snapshot, but I'll show you the worksheet also, spreadsheet also. So now you will just click Microsoft Excel. You will enter the data like this. As I've talked, here you put the title, then you put the column's name, like weight added and extension produced. Okay, then we go to insert part. In insert part, there are charts. We open those charts, and there are a number of charts. And how we make use of those charts, that is important again. If you go to insert, you will see these charts. And these there are line charts, area charts, pie charts, scatter chart, bar chart, and other charts are there. We don't have to make use of all the charts. You know that the pie graph we and bar chart we normally use when we have one variable as categorical variable. Categorical variable means, suppose I am studying gender or weight or height. Okay, so then I can make use of pie chart. And line graphs we use when we have the both dependent and independent variables which are continuous. So I hope you know that dependent variable we normally plot along y-axis and independent variable along x-axis. But if we want to study the relationship, actually, we want to see the association of the different variables, we make use of scatter plots. So in physics, normally we try to see the scatter plots. Okay, so you don't have to get yourself confused here. Just go to scatter plot if you have two variables. And if you want to study the association, what type of a relation these two variables are having. Okay, so this is pie chart, this is your line chart, and this is the scatter chart. So, and then you can again decorate your chart also by going to layout. Layout is there. Here, the menu, you will see the layout. Layout will give you these options. You can enter the chart title. You can enter the axis title. You can format your axis. A lot of things you can do in your chart. Okay, so let's go to the scatter plot first. And I will take another spreadsheet here. Okay, I'll show you. 1 minute, I'll just go to the exercises part. And okay, spring balance cases, a case I have taken. So I'll show you that only. This is spring balance. So I have talked about, this is your heading. This is weight added, extension produced, these are the weight, these are the extension produced. Then what I do, I select these two things. Now see that how I'm going to do all this. I'll just delete this graph for a moment. Okay, so I highlight these two variables. Now by default, you know, this column, which is on the left side, this is X in a spreadsheet, and this is Y. By default, a spreadsheet will plot this along x-axis, and this will be plotted on y-axis. But you can always change this value. You can always change the address. X, Y, up parameters change kar sakte ho apne graph mein. But, and then you go to insert here. Yeah, insert pe jao. This is showing you the charts, different charts. Okay, I go to scatter one, scatter plot. And I choose a scatter graph. And I am getting this graph. So this is a graph I'm getting. Okay, now this is a very raw graph. I don't have anything here. This is not explaining anything to me. So I can enter the chart title. I can say that spring balance. So I can put here the chart title. If you see that when I'm typing spring balance, it's coming here. It's coming here. So when I press enter, I will get the chart title here. Okay, so for axis, again, highlight this your chart, and you can say add the axis name. You can add the switch rows column. You can select the data type of chart. यहाँ से आप shift भी कर सकते हो. I have taken scatter. You can go to another chart from here. Okay. So So if I highlight any point here, you see that it's giving me this highlighted. I mean, this is showing me that these points are reflecting this data here. Okay. So this way we add the scatter plot. If I want to add some other part, I can choose this. I can go to insert and I can take even the bar chart and I can plot the bar chart. Okay, it's my choice. You have to see the nature of your data and then you have to choose the type of a chart you want to have. Now say that I can take a pie chart also. I can put a pie chart, but it's not giving me any sense for a moment. Okay, so I can add this chart to my or graph to my data. This is the beauty of spreadsheet. You can do all these things with this spreadsheet. Now let me show you one more spreadsheet here. I'll take this. Now this I'm taking because you know, these are the graphs we normally found in a physics class. Now here I see that I have shown you these comments. You can see here a comment, but you cannot see here a comment because here I have hidden it and here I'm showing it. Okay, so you can, it's your choice where you want to put your comment. You want to hide it or you want to show it. You can do that with that option, which I've already shown you. Graph one is I having X variable and Y variable. X is my independent variable, which is coming along X axis, and this is Y axis. So this is just a straight line. Okay, I have taken a data, X is changing, but Y is not changing. So I'm getting this data. So I have explained it here. As X increases, Y remains the same. Okay, normally we do it in a distance time graph. Okay, so time is changing, but the distance is not changing. The body is at rest. So we come across these graphs in physics. Second graph is showing me a straight line where X is changing, X is increasing, Y is also increasing. So it's giving me a straight line curve, Y equivalent to MX plus B. M is the slope of this line and B is the Y intercept. I will tell you how to get the slope from the graph and the intercept also in my next talk that I'll cover tomorrow. How you can go above to find the best fit line and slope and all. Here I'm just showing you how we can have a plot in spreadsheet. Now this is a graph between 1 upon x, y versus 1 upon x. Here I've taken, initially I've taken y equivalent to x plus 1. Now I'm talking about y is decreasing as you are increasing x. So here I can explain this also by putting a comment. As x increases, y decreases. Y is inversely proportional to x, like we have it in Boyle's law. Our pressure is inversely proportional to volume. So we get this type of a graph over there. If we have a negative value, so we will get this type of a graph also. So if you see, I have taken a set of negative values also, so I'm getting this curve here.
Sapna, there is one small comment which I want to make.
Yes, sir.
Actually, this title should be not versus, but proportionally. Because versus actually gives us a different feeling.
Okay.
Y versus X. But the relationship is Y proportional to 1 upon X.
Okay.
X square and so on. So this is small, right, you know, sometimes okay. One may get confused about it.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir. I will just do this correction. I'll make this correction. So the next is giving me Y is proportional to X square. So I'm getting a parabolic type of a curve here. Okay, so I have just taken a random values 0, 1, 2, 3. You can always generate these values. This is also a feature. I put 1, 2, and I say 3. Sorry. If I say 2 here and select this, put your cursor here and just drag it, these values will automatically come. So I've just taken these values like this and then the square of it. And life has become very simple. So these are different graphs which I have just drawn for you, that you can have a feeling of this relationship by drawing such graphs, taking any type of a data. So my suggestion is that if you have performed any experiment in your lab, take that data and try to plot in the spreadsheet. So this was the one exercise I want to show you. The next exercise I would like to show you is, if you have any question, kindly ask the questions also, please. This is the trigonometric function. You know, sir has given us a beautiful graph yesterday, three graphs, how we get this sine curve by, he has explained the approximation very nicely. Now, you know, last time there was a question that, this sine when we plot this sine or trigonometric function, it will always take the values in radian. Okay, so there are two ways to get the radian. The one is that I have taken x value here. Here, if you see the next column, I put a formula b3 plus 15. It means I am giving an increment of 15 to my previous value. So I just say 0 and I put here this increment in spreadsheet and then I drag it. So once I drag, I don't have to enter every value. That is there. If I say put a formula, drag it, you will automatically get all these values. Then I have converted it into radians. So I have put another formula that this value multiplied by 3.142 divided by 180. So this is the you get values in radian, and then in the next column I have taken sine of this column C3, sine of this value, and sine is the function, inbuilt function in this spreadsheet. So this is one way of doing this. Or then I plotted this graph between x and sine x. If I highlight any point here, you will see these two columns. It's giving me these two columns, so I'm getting a sine curve here. Okay, other way is that I put this 0 and I put this formula and get all these values here. I've just copy pasted it from here. And then I use that function, which is inbuilt. I said sine of radian of this address, P3. P is the address, P is column, third is the row. So P3, I have given the address. So sine of radian P3. Iska radian nikalo, P3 mein jo hai, aur uska sine le lo. So I get these values. So now I select this values, get this curve. I've taken a scatter plot and do it here. I go to insert, I take the scatter plot and plot it. So I'm getting this scatter plot. taken the values up to the 630, 645. So I've taken these values like this. So there are two ways of entering. You can put a formula. You can make your own formula and do it like that. Or you can use the inbuilt function of spreadsheet. And I'll show you the formulas here. I want to talk about the functions also. So here I'm talking about, this is known as function, insert function. If you go to formulas, there is a key here, insert function. Okay, so insert function, it's showing us these functions. These are the function library, you call it. You have auto sum, you have financial functions, day, time, mathematics, and trigonometric function. Then more functions are also there. Statistical, engineering, cube, information, all these functions. I don't know. I haven't used many of these functions. I'm just using the simple one. Okay, so now here, this is insert function, which is important for us. So from here, I have just taken this. So if I type here, I'll get this value from inbuilt function. Okay, is things are clear up to this point?
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
In cell C3, you have used the approximate value of pi for the conversion from degree to radian.
Yeah.
Is there any provision that we can use the exact value of pi? Is there any
exact value of pi means?
You have used the formula 3.142.
Huh? You mean to say that you want to use that some more decimal points?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Yes, yes. There is a provision here. I'll show you. You can put here. I'll show you that also. One sec, huh? I'll show you. You go to home. Okay. Here there is a point. Yeah, number hai na jahan pe. Here you can increase or decrease the decimals. Suppose I take here any value, I can put here increase or decrease the number. Ye hai yahan pe. This is for?
He's asking whether we can take all the decimal points of pi or as many as the computer can have. So pi, open bracket, close bracket is the term.
Okay, I got it. I mean, okay. Instead of 3.142, if you type pi and that, then it's going to give you the value.
Okay. May I come in?
Equals pi, open bracket, close bracket. Just write it in one cell, he will understand.
Say this.
Equal.
I will say equal to.
Again, function pi.
Pi, open bracket, close bracket. After pi, open bracket, close bracket.
Like this.
And enter. Enter.
Do you want to accept this? Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Now it
thank
is giving
thank
you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Go to a number of significant figures over here.
Yeah.
I just want to add something. May I?
Yes, sir.
You know, this is a very interesting point where you can check something else also. You know that you can always select for a given cell what you are entering, what is called format. So whether format is text or a number, you can always decide. So here we are by default using number as the format. Have an option that up to how many decimal places you can really get it. So if you increase that number of decimal places, you will find that, you know, yesterday I was mentioning in my presentation that you can have up to 8 digits or up to 15 digit precision. So you can check how much precision you can have in your worksheet, up to 8 decimal places or 15 decimal places or 20 decimal places and so on.
So you can see it. I'm adding decimal points. You can see it.
Yeah. So what is being done is
zero.
No,
Sapna, you are adding zeros.
No. I'm not adding it to zeros. I'm just increasing the decimal point. See, from here.
Yeah.
I'm adding.
But what I was saying was,
I can reduce it.
What I was saying. Yeah. So what I was saying was that this number is given correct up to how many decimal places? Sapna, read it up to 9 only. How many decimal places are there?
13.
Yes.
So now you know that this is the limit up to which you can go, because pi is a rational number. It doesn't end, you know, it doesn't terminate anywhere.
Yes.
You can go right up to 100 decimal places or 200 decimal places and on. But here you are.
So you can, check it.
Yes, ma'am, you are saying something?
No, maximum 16 digits. Here you are getting maximum of 16 digits.
Yeah, maximum of 16 digits. Yes. Yes. So I think this, you know, helps us to see that point also, which we were making yesterday. In the, okay.
Yes. 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 Definitely.
Prithviraj, very good. You asked a good question.
Very nice. Very good question. Yes. Great.
So Prithviraj is very active, watching,
yes.
Observing. Very good.
Yes, and such students make class more active, and you also become active. Okay, so any other question, or should I proceed?
Excuse me, madam. एक query थी मेरी यहाँ पर कि अगर जैसे BSc final के ना practicals में हम जब frequency वाला और voltage gain वाला graph plot करवाते हैं बच्चों के लिए, उसमें जो data range होती है, that goes from hertz to megahertz. तो उस केस में अगर डेटा रेंज बहुत ज़्यादा बड़ी हो तो फिर भी ग्राफ प्लॉट हो सकता है इसमें एक्सेल में.
हाँ, बिल्कुल हो जाएगा सर, है ना, बिल्कुल हो जाएगा. इस सर आप उसको ट्राई करें, हो जाता है ग्राफ प्लॉट.
क्योंकि उसमें डेटा रेंज होती है ना एक्स एक्सिस में, डेट गोज फ्रॉम सपोज 50 हर्ट्ज एंड गो अप टू मेगा हर्ट्ज, तो उसमें फिर ये प्रॉब्लम तो नहीं आती इसकी.
मुझे लगता है सर वो स्केल उसका एडजस्ट हो जाएगा ना उस हिसाब से. आपकी वो जो 50 हर्ट्ज की वैल्यू है वो बहुत कम छोटी सी दिखेगी, बट ग्राफ आ जाएगा आपका. ऐसा नहीं है ग्राफ नहीं आएगा, ग्राफ आ जाएगा सर.
डॉक्टर साहब, देयर इज वन मोर सॉल्यूशन टू दैट आल्सो. व्हेनेवर यू फाइंड दैट योर स्केल इज सच दैट सम वैल्यूज आर वेरी स्मॉल एंड सम वैल्यूज आर वेरी लार्ज, so instead of using, you know, those values, you can use some kind of a logarithmic scale.
Logarithmic,
हाँ. But that is one option. बिल्कुल ठीक है. लेकिन अगर हमने simple वही scale में करना हो तो वो check करना पड़ेगा. उसमें भी हो सकता है कि
नहीं, वो हो जाएगा, मगर आपको ना कुछ values ऐसे नजर आएंगे कि वो कुछ भी नहीं होएंगी. जो है ना उसमें interval आप जब choose करोगे तो वो थोड़ा सा इतना बड़ी value है megahertz. और एक हर्ट्स है स्केल आप 10^6 तक लेके जा रहे हो तो वो ना बीच में बैठता नहीं है ठीक ढंग से. तो इसीलिए हम लॉगरिथमिक स्केल्स का भी इस्तेमाल करते हैं. दैट इज द सिचुएशन वेयर वी यूज दोस.
पर सर ग्राफ तो आ जाता है. पर सर ग्राफ तो आ जाएगा.
ग्राफ आ जाएगा, इज नो प्रॉब्लम.
हां, पर वैल्यू, वो छोटी वाली वैल्यू देखनी थोड़ी मुश्किल हो जाएगी.
ओके ओके.
तो आगे मैं प्रोसीड करूं फिर?
यस यस यस.
So, ये एक और नेक्स्ट स्प्रेडशीट आई वांटेड टू शो यू, बिकॉज़ ये दिस टॉपिक भी वी टीच इट इन ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन. दिस स्प्रेडशीट इज फॉर ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन. ओके, सो हियर आई हैव ट्राइड टू मेक अ कंप्लीट स्प्रेडशीट. लाइक आई सर वाज टॉकिंग, व्हेनेवर यू मेक अ स्प्रेडशीट यू ट्राई टू डिवाइड इट इनटू 3 पार्ट्स. सो दिस इज माय होम ब्लॉक where I put all the values, and this is the work block where I do the calculations, and this is my graphical block. Okay, now this value can show me, I mean, this can act as a simulation also, which sir was mentioning yesterday. Here I have substituted the values which are constant. I think somebody's mic is on, kindly please switch it off. Okay, so here I've substituted the values h, velocity of light, and Boltzmann constant. I've calculated this value also, and this is my control parameter. And here I've made a comment also that if I change this temperature of this cell to view the changes in the shape of the curve at different temperature. So here, and this part I have done all the calculations. So these are the formula. You see, I have made it like in every step I have tried to break the whole formula for energy, jo intensity aati thi, usko chote steps mein I have broken it. So first I have tried to calculate hc upon lambda kt. Then I have taken the exponential of this. Then I have tried to subtract 1 from it. Then I have taken the reciprocal of this whole factor. And then I've taken here lambda 5 and then substituted it in the complete formula. So I have done calculation in bits. And finally, I have substituted the things in one formula. And then formula has become very simple. This I have done for my convenience. You can do it in a single step also. You can always divide your problem into single steps and do the calculations. But by doing these small steps, you know, the calculations part remain actually slightly easy also, and accuracy part also. You can easily find out that where is the problem in your formula. So that's why I've done it like this. Now, suppose that I change the temperature. I can do it simply. You can see that we can easily see the shift in the graph, change in the graph. I have from 3500, I have made it less. 2000. I can make it 3000. Now you can check the shift in the graph or change in the graph. Okay, so this can be easily shown to the students and like this.
Please make it 2000 again.
Okay, sir.
Zoom it. Zoom the work. Please zoom the work after making it 2000. Just वो लास्ट वाले कॉलम नजर आना चाहिए वर्क ब्लॉक का.
एक मिनट सर.
जूम. या
ठीक है.
इसको 2000 करो.
चलो नाउ लेट मी मेक इट 2000 एंड यू कैन सी द चेंज. और आपको यहां वैल्यू भी दिखने शुरू.
आई वांट टू टेल यू समथिंग एल्स व्हिच यू मस्ट हैव नोटिस्ड. यू नो दैट इन द लास्ट कॉलम आपके पास जहां ई लिखा हुआ है आपके पास ना ये हैश 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 लिख के आ गए हुए. Now what has happened? Now here, you know, there was a number small in terms of 10 raised to power minus something. And spreadsheet had a limitation that it cannot go to that number. It will treat that number as something very small. So sometimes make it 3000. Let us see what is that number sitting there.
Okay.
Now see, it is 10 raised to power minus 90.
Sir, earlier it was minus 142. If I make it 2000, it's giving me the value.
Yes, it is there. But then again, there is a limitation that Ashesh ka bata hai, isne calculate kari hai value.
Haan, bilkul kari hai.
To fit in your format somewhere.
Yes.
So, you must keep an eye on such things also. Dekhi, kya ho raha hai? Ghabrane wali baat nahi hai isme kuch bhi. You have to keep an eye on what is happening. Kya calculations ho rahi hai humare paas. One thing more in writing of this, that Sapna brought this lambda last of all, though she is plotting lambda versus the intensity curve. Yeah, so she could have brought this lambda also in the beginning itself, so that everything, you know, remains in the sequence, because that is going as an input. Yeah, aapke na arbitrary possibilities hain, kuch bhi galat nahi hota hai isme. आपने जब जिस चीज को कहीं डाल लिया वो अपने आप उसको उठा के लेगा.
हाँ, वो उसका एड्रेस को ले लेगा.
एड्रेस को वो ले लेगा. सो दीज आर सम यू नो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटीज व्हिच आर अवेलेबल टू अस व्हाइल वर्किंग इन द स्प्रेडशीट.
एंड व्हाई आई हैव टेकन लैम्डा टू दिस साइड बिकॉज़ आई वांटेड टू प्लॉट अ ग्राफ बिटवीन लैम्डा एंड ई. सो आई हैव सेड दैट लेट लैम्डा एंड ई बी टुगेदर ओनली. मैं इसको पहले भी रख सकती हूँ. आई कैन चेंज द एड्रेस ऑल्सो.
अनदर फीचर व्हिच इज इमर्जिंग इन व्हाट सपना हैज सेड. सपना एक्चुअली वांटेड कि ये जो बीच की है ना कॉलम्स, इसमें हमारे पास वो कॉलम्स के सारे ग्राफ आने थे साथ में, अगर सारा सेलेक्ट कर लेती है. व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज समटाइम्स व्हेन यू हैव सच ए सिचुएशन वेयर लैम्डा कम्स इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ थिंग्स आर लेटर, इन बिटवीन कॉलम्स यू नीड टू हाइड. सो यू कैन हाइड दोज कॉलम्स एंड देन अगेन यू विल गेट लैम्डा वर्सेस ई कर्व ओनली. सो द कैलकुलेशंस आर देयर बट यू हैव जस्ट हिट दोज. So to keep the transparency, I think Sapna did it very nicely that she kept it here so that things can work accordingly.
this was done deliberately to show each and every part of the calculations to students. I mean, how I have arrived up to intensity. So these were the small parts, small calculations done. For
and there is one thing more which I would like to really comment on. आमतौर पे देखो जो आप कुकल में बात कर रहा था ये जो पहली लाइन आपने लिखी हुई है ना यहाँ पे सारी आपकी थिंकिंग चली हुई है आपको पहले सबसे पहले यही लाइन लिखनी है उसके बाद तो क्या कर सकते हो आप इस लाइन को सिलेक्ट करो और एक इंक्रीमेंट आप कितनी करना चाहते हो इस नंबर में जो यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है वो अगर डाल लो और आगे पुल डाउन कर दो तो सारा का सारा एक मिनट में कैलकुलेशन आपके सामने होकर के आ जाती है. तो नॉर्मली व्हाट पीपल डू इज जब वो आपने कहीं रिपोर्ट में भी बताना है कि आपने कैलकुलेशन कैसे करी है तो एक लाइन सिर्फ जिसमें आपने सारी कैलकुलेशन करी हुई है वो दिखानी है. एवरीथिंग बिकम्स ट्रांसपेरेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस. ऐसे कैलकुलेशन हुई हुई. आई होप दिस स्मॉल ट्रिक यू विल कीप इन माइंड कि हमको थॉट प्रोसेस में जस्ट एक लाइन जो है ना एक रो उसमें हमने अपना ध्यान फोकस कर लिया बाकी चीजें तो बहुत ईजी है जितना मर्जी आगे बढ़ा लो. या थैंक यू सपना.
Okay, sir. So let me proceed. I mean, with this say spreadsheet, we can easily explain Wien's displacement law, Stefan's law, etc., etc. See, as I change the temperature, the wavelength is shifting. You can see the shift in the wavelength. This is 3000. So if I make it 3053, you can see the shift.
May I suggest one exercise here? Sapna,
Hanji sir.
For the students particularly, you can go to the virtual lab at Amrita, and they have a black body radiation experiment there itself. And you can really take data from there, and then try to plot the graphs there itself. And so here, this is all theoretical calculation. And then you have this set of values, which are theoretical values. So what you can see is, I did an experiment. I had a theory. Let me see if I plot both the graphs together on the same graph, whether theory matches with the experiment or not. So ye ek asal mein hum in cheezon ko aise istemal karenge, to hume kafi cheezein clear nazar aane lagengi. So aajkal to hum virtual mode mein kaam kar rahe hain. So why not do this experiment virtually itself and then try to see all these things. बट अगर आप वर्चुअल में नहीं है आपने क्लासरूम मोड में इनके इस एक्सपेरिमेंट को करा हुआ है नो प्रॉब्लम हम इसको फिर भी करके देख सकते हैं. सो आई होप मे बी वी विल डिजाइन एन एक्सरसाइज एंड वी विल आस्क यू टू गो टू द वर्चुअल लैब एंड डू समथिंग. प्लीज डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स डू रिमेंबर वन थिंग हमारा क्लासरूम ना एक महीने के लिए खुला रहेगा. तो हम जो ये एक्सरसाइजेस की बात कर रहे हैं ना आप जा सकते हो वहां पे वो एक्सरसाइज कर सकते हो एंड यू कैन पोस्ट योर रिजल्ट्स इन द क्लासरूम इटसेल्फ फॉर अदर्स टू सी. वंडरफुल एक्सप्लोरेशन व्हिच यू कैन रियली मैनेज एंड डू. या सबसे
मैं आई जस्ट कंक्लूड क्योंकि आपको मैक्रोस के ऊपर भी बात करनी है थोड़ी सी.
थोड़ा जैसा करना है मुझे ज्यादा
टाइम. सर आई जस्ट शो वन और एक जो.
श्योर श्योर टेक योर ओन टाइम डोंट वरी.
नहीं सर ये मैं जरा दिखाना चाह रही थी लाइक दिस ऑल्सो. हाँ दिस ऑल्सो वी स्टडी व्हेन वी स्टडी द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ पार्टिकल इनसाइड अ बॉक्स. तो वो सारी चीजें पार्टिकल इनसाइड अ बॉक्स जब हम पढ़ते हैं वी कैन मेक दिस ग्राफ. आई डोंट नो वेदर ऑल स्टूडेंट्स हैव स्टडीड इट और नॉट बट हियर व्हेन यू चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ द स्टेट द ग्राफ चेंजेस. द ओनली थिंग इज आई वॉन्ट टू शो यू द सिमुलेशन कैसे ये आप एक वैल्यू चेंज करके एक पैरामीटर को चेंज करके how can the shape of the graph can change wo aap bata sakte ho. Suppose I take the number state 1. Okay, so it means I'm talking about the ground state, then the wave function and probability curve goes like this. You can just have to observe it. If I change the state to 2, ab dekho graph kaise change ho raha hai ye main dikhana cha rahi hu. I am not bothered about the calculations and all ye third. So ye ek टाइप से स्प्रेडशीट जो है सिमुलेशन की तरह एक्ट करता है. लाइक वी कैन चेंज द वेरिएबल चेंज द पैरामीटर एंड वी कैन इजीली एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट इन द क्लासरूम कि अगर हम ये स्टेट चेंज कर रहे हैं तो हमारे वेव फंक्शन और प्रोबेबिलिटी में क्या डिफरेंस आ रहा है. आप भी इसको प्लॉट करके यू कैन ऑल्सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड कि ये चेंजेस कैसे आती हैं. सो ये कैलकुलेशंस वगैरह मुझे नहीं बता रही थी, होम ब्लॉक, वर्क ब्लॉक, ग्राफिक ब्लॉक इसकी बात हो चुकी है, ये मेरी कैलकुलेशंस है, आई हैव जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूटेड द फॉर्मूला, वो मैंने आपको यहाँ बता दिया कि फॉर्मूला हम कैसे लगाते हैं, इन सब का सिंबल्स का मतलब भी बता दिया, एब्सोल्यूट एंड रिलेटिव रेफरेंसेस के थ्रू हम कैसे काम करते हैं, ये सब चीजें एक्सप्लेन कर दी गई हैं। एक और था जो हम सिंपल कैलकुलेशन, आई एम नॉट शोइंग यू एनी ग्राफ, बट दिस इज एक्चुअली द व्हेन वी टीच स्टैटिस्टिकल फिजिक्स और कहीं और मैथमेटिक्स में स्टर्लिंग फॉर्मूला की बात आती है, वो एक अप्रोक्सीमेशन की बात आती है, सो दैट अप्रोक्सीमेशन कैन बी सीन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस स्प्रेडशीट, आप नंबर को सब्स्टिट्यूट करके यू कैन जनरेट द वैल्यूज एंड कंपेयर द थिंग्स. The formula is log of n factorial is n log n minus n. So this blue or ye jo pizza part hai, that is actually the formula. So aap in dono ki values ko compare kar sakte ho. If n is less, to values mein difference hai. But as we increase the value of n, the difference becomes less. Aur par wohi baat hai ki aake yahan pe jaake ye limitation hai ki isse upar ye calculate nahin kar sakta. So the Stirling formula is actually gives us a correct value if the number is very large. Statistical, hum statistics hum tabhi apply kar sakte hain if the number is very large. So these small, small exercises can be easily carried out in spreadsheet to see the, so to verify the things what we are learning in the classroom. That was the aim of showing you all these spreadsheets, small spreadsheets in my presentation.
Just for a minute, Sapna.
Hanji, sir.
देखिए वंस अगेन नाउ वी हैव एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू लर्न समथिंग हियर. फॉर एग्जांपल यू वांट टू फाइंड से फैक्टोरियल, तो आपने 20 फैक्टोरियल, 30 फैक्टोरियल, 40 फैक्टोरियल, आप देखो आपकी स्प्रेडशीट की लिमिटेशंस कहाँ है, इतना बड़े से बड़ा फैक्टोरियल आप लिख सकते हो, एंड देन यू विल स्टार्ट अप्रिशिएटिंग दैट व्हाई पीपल ऑलवेज यू नो व्हेन दे गो टू स्टैटिस्टिकल मैकेनिक्स एंड वांट टू डू समथिंग विद दीज this n factorial which comes and which is corresponding to n is very large in fact. So they always try to make use of the Stirling's approximation. And aap kya kar sakte ho, n factorial which is being calculated by your spreadsheet and one which is being which is calculated by your n log n minus n formula, unka plot aap karke dekh lo. I think Sapna you did that plot also, na?
कौन सा सर?
N factorial versus n log n का ग्राफ बनाया था?
नहीं ग्राफ नहीं बनाया, but I have done in next class का. ये कर रहा है, मैं ये दिखाना चाह रही हूँ एक्चुअली में. एक और है ये पेंडुलम का एक्सपेरिमेंट में केस में किया, सिंपल पेंडुलम के केस में.
हाँ हाँ ओके.
सिंपल पेंडुलम के केस में वांटेड टू टेक दिस केस एक्चुअली. ये सिंपल पेंडुलम में लेट मी कम बैक टू माय प्रेजेंटेशन. I'll take 5 minutes, sir. Simple pendulum experiment mein, when we simple experiment mein kya hota, we just try to find out the time period of a simple pendulum. And by changing the length, we measure the time period. Or sir has talked about kyun hum small amplitude lete hai, or everything was made clear to you yesterday. And we make use of this formula and calculate the value of G. Or kya karte hai, graph plot kiya jata hai between L and T square. Straight line comes, slope is taken, substituted, and to get the value of G. So we normally plot a graph between L and T square. The third part हम देख करते हैं lab में, okay? और G की value निकालते हैं. I just want you to do to plot a graph between L and T, also a graph between log L, log L and log T, and see what do you understand. So I've done a small calculation also. When we plot a graph between length versus time, then what does it give? If I plot a graph between log L and log T, what does it give? And log L by L and T square, how they are different from each other? You can make a comparison and you can check the values also. So this is an exercise which you can do yourself. I have already done. If you want, I can show it to you or I can put it in a Google Classroom so that you can check it. Similarly, you can do this quadratic equation exercise also with you, which I'm not going to take because sir has to talk about macros today. So this was, I'm just giving you a homework. Homework is that you can take a set of reading from any experiment you have performed and you can plot these graphs. You can at least try to plot the graph so that if you have any difficulty in plotting the graph, I'm there tomorrow also. with my talk, I can discuss those difficulties tomorrow. So with this, I come to end of my presentation. Thank you for hearing me patiently.
Wonderful. Great. I really enjoyed it.
I hope so, sir. You have enjoyed it. Thank you so much.
And
I have enjoyed it too.
Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Ma'am. I hope students have already, a student must have enjoyed it. I wish they have also enjoyed it. So I will stop presenting my screen and hand over the things to Professor Ahluwalia, because he has to continue with the macros and visual basic, which is a part of this spreadsheet only. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
So what I'll do is, Sapna, you have already withdrawn from presentation, so I will try to present now something.
You want me to show those spreadsheet? I can, sir. I can do that.
No, nothing. मुझे कुछ नहीं चाहिए, मैं अपने हिसाब से करूंगा, राइट?
ठीक,
सो डोंट वरी अबाउट इट.
ओके सर.
सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग बैक टू यूट्यूब एंड वी हैव यू नो समथिंग विच इज very, very interesting that I'll just go on top and show you that we did last time that what is XCL, Excel VBA, and maybe recording a kind of a macro, etc. In this. So let me really try to see if I can really go
that
to...
Is not Grammarly can help. This sentence is grammatically correct,
so
it's wordy.
Let me just skip that.
Welcome to Tutorials Point. This
and let me try to go to this video.
In this video, we'll see how to record a simple basic macro. If you're looking at this video for the first time, if you're new to this macro part, VBA part, this is the simplest and easiest method by which you can record a macro. Recording a macro will record all the actions you do on this sheet. If you try to make it as bold, italic, underline, sorting, filtering, everything, whatever you do, it will record in the form of VBA script, okay, and the backend, form of macro. Now, what are the things you have to follow? Okay, in this place, you have to follow some few things for recording a macro. Observe this. When you do it actually in the practical time, it will hardly take 1 minute, not more than that. Okay, so let us see that. Now I've created a blank sheet that is record a macro. Okay, and Excel VBA is the workbook given here. Now, if I want to record a macro, you have to go to this developer tab. And if you see, there's a button given as record a macro. Now, before that, you see there's an option given as use relative rep.
Let me just come back and tell you something which is quite crucial at this stage, which you must really keep in mind. And that is basically the following. That when you try to really go to the macros, you need to do a small change in your Excel toolbar. And what is that? You should have this developer here, which is already talking about it. So you know that you can bring in very many things here on the toolbar, and developer is one of those tools which should be visible to us. If it is not visible, then we will not be able to do it. I hope you will remember this, that go to the toolbar, select developer there. This developer will appear here. Once it is there, then and only then you can go ahead with this recording of the macros and recording of the Visual Basic modules, which you can create otherwise also in VBA. So I will continue from here what he is trying to tell. Work in your spreadsheet. Let me just come here. I am back here. You will find that here is, let me just zoom it also. Let me try to.
Yes.
Let me just zoom it.
At bottom, sir.
just for a minute. मैं इसको 200 पे ले जा रहा हूँ. आई होप यू कैन सी अ फ्यू थिंग्स हियर. ये देखिए यहाँ पे ना ये डेवलपर वाला लिंक है. ये मैंने इसको एक बार फिर मैं किसी कहीं और पे जाके वापस इसके ऊपर आता हूँ. ये डेवलपर है. ओके कैन यू सी इट दैट व्हेन यू हैव टू रिकॉर्ड ए मैक्रो दिस डेवलपर शुड बी अवेलेबल टू यू. If it is not available, you will not be able to see. Somebody's mic is on actually. Please switch it off. So you will not be able to record macros. This is the first requirement which is there. And say, let me try to go to here in various, you know, menus. Unless this developer is there, you will not be able to do anything. And you need to really go to first view. View में ना आपको यहाँ पे टूल बार वाला पार्ट भी नजर आता है. I hope I am somewhere there only. Data view. Wherever I was, formula bar show insert table. कई बार मैं भूल भी जाता हूँ मैंने कहाँ उसको देखा हुआ था. बट देर इज ऑलवेज ए टूल बार. अगर आप वर्ड वगैरह में भी काम करते हो ना तो उसमें भी आपको नजर आती हैं चीजें. वो टूल बार आप इंसर्ट कर सकते हो. मेरे को यहाँ पे अब ढूंढने में टाइम लगेगा. बट नॉर्मली हम ना व्यू में जाकर के उसको हम देख सकते हैं. व्यू साइड बाय साइड स्विच मैक्रोस क्या क्या बनी हुई हैं वो आप देख सकते हो. बट मे बी टुमारो आई विल टेल यू आफ्टर सर्चिंग इट. इमीजिएटली मुझे नजर नहीं आ रहा है कि कहाँ पे है बिकॉज उसमें से कई चीजें आप ऑन कर सकते हो. मैं आपको सिर्फ एक चीज बताना चाह रहा था. तो मैंने आपको ये स्प्रेडशीट दिखाई थी. ओके मैंने इसमें कुछ कैलकुलेशंस करी थी. और जब मैंने ये कैलकुलेशंस करी थी तो यहाँ देखिए यहाँ पे क्या लिखा हुआ है. सेकंड टर्म. ये सेकंड टर्म कहाँ से आई. यहाँ पे फॉर्मूला तो कुछ भी नहीं लिखा हुआ है मैंने. तो मैंने गो टू डेवलपर एंड आई ट्राई टू सी से विजुअल बेसिक. आई एम एबल टू सी समथिंग विच यू नो दैट फेलो वॉज ट्राइंग टू शो फॉर कलरिंग ए सेल इटसेल्फ. मैंने यहाँ पे एक फंक्शन डिफाइन करा. दिस इज वॉट वी कॉल एज अ यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन. और वहां पे मैंने थर्ड टर्म ऐड करके थर्ड टर्म तक जो उसकी सीरीज एक्सपेंशन थी साइन एक्स की वो लिख दी. दैट वाज व्हाट एक्स माइनस एक्स रेस्ट पावर 3 डिवाइडेड बाय दिस 6 एंड देन एक्स रेस्ट पावर 5 विद अ प्लस साइन डिवाइडेड बाय 120. दीज आर 3 फैक्टोरियल एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट दैट 5 फैक्टोरियल. मे बी यू कैन ऑल्सो हैव ए फंक्शन समवेयर विच कैन कैलकुलेट फैक्टोरियल फॉर यू. बट फॉर माई पार्ट दिस वाज ओके. What I do is when I write it and when I come back and then I can, you know, insert a macro here in any one of these cells. So, मेरे पास एक list of macros आ जाती है. जैसे मैंने जैसे यहाँ पे से equal to का sign डाला और अगर मैं जैसे सपना बता रही थी को मैं function introduce करना चाहता हूँ तो मेरे पास functions की यहाँ पे ना लिस्ट आने लग जाती है. कुछ फंक्शन है जो बिल्ट इन फंक्शन है, कुछ फंक्शन है जो यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन है. तो आई हैव टू एक्चुअली गेट यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन एंड नॉट बिल्ट इन फंक्शन. सो लेट मी जस्ट कैंसल इट. आई एम नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग. सो यू कैन कम टू द मैक्रोस पार्ट ऑल्सो दैट वट आर दोज मैक्रोज विच यू हैव एक्चुअली क्रिएटेड एंड यू कैन हैव ए लिस्ट ऑफ द मैक्रोज ऑल्सो कि आप उस लिस्ट में आप जा पा रहे हो या नहीं जा पा रहे हो. वंस यू आर एबल टू गो देयर यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली फाइंड दैट दैट फॉर्मूला विल कम हियर. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई राइट हियर से देयर इज अ नेम व्हिच आई हैव गिवन टू दिस मैक्रो. दिस वाज सेकंड टर्म. सो लेट मी राइट डाउन हियर इक्वल टू एंड देन सेकंड टर्म. कैन यू सी दैट दिस मैक्रोज व्हिच आई हैव रिटन दैट अपीयर्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्मॉल पुल डाउन मेनू. And here is the second term. So if I just press it, you will find that it will come. Then I have to really write down
second term, if I have to calculate, then what variable I have to take? So variable, say I pick up from here, and then I just close this bracket. So I'm just closing this bracket just for a minute. Yeah. Right, and let me enter. You will find that ये देखिए मैंने second term तक का जो sine की extension थी उसकी value यहाँ पे मेरे पास calculate होकर के आ गई. So now you can see that आप macro record भी कर सकते हो और यह macro आप क्या कर सकते हो यहाँ पे visual basic में जा करके आपको ये अगर macro लिखना चाहते हो तो वो macro आप लिख सकते हो. You can create a macro if you want to really edit a macro, you can do that, and all sorts of things can be done here. So what I have done here is I have given it a name function. You can also give name sub. Jaise agar aapne wo pichli video dekhi hai, to usme when he tried to write down that macro, by default the title which came was sub only, but in this case the title I have kept as function. This is also recognized by the spreadsheet. The Excel spreadsheet that he is going to write function. So I give a name in front of it, then I try to define it, and this is an argument which actually goes in writing this particular macro itself. So what I will suggest you is that you please try to look at, I have already posted this spreadsheet in Classroom. There is another thing which is very crucial which we must really remember. Whenever you have to really run macros in a worksheet, what you are supposed to do is you need to save it as something which has got a macro. So jab aap save as mein jaate ho to save as karte waqt aapke paas na ek values aati hain ki aap save as isko kaise karna chahte ho. Suppose I am trying to save it somewhere, right? Now when I come here, I find that you can see here that I have saved it as Excel macro enabled workbook. मेरे पास और भी काफी पॉसिबिलिटीज थी. Excel workbook, ordinary macros will not run in that. And if you don't save it like this, any module which you have generated, you will find that that will not get saved because that is not part of the Excel workbook itself. So the first thing which you do is that when you save this, you must make sure that you have saved it as a Excel macro enabled workbook, and then you will see that instead of extension .xls only, an M also comes and sits with it. Am I clear? Are you getting what I am trying to say?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is what you need to really keep in mind, and I think this is the trick. Rest is very, very simple. Rest you will find will happen very, very easily. अब देखो मैंने क्या किया था, मैंने ये आप इसको मैक्रो बोल लो या इसको यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन बोल लो, जैसे आप चाहो वैसे इसको बोल लो. मैंने कोई मैक्रो नहीं बनाई है इसलिए मैक्रो की लिस्ट में नहीं शो कर रहा था, बट जो जब यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन की तरह मैंने उसको बनाया तो मेरे को वहां पे जैसे मैं इक्वल टू नाम लिखने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ, देन इट इज शोइंग मी दैट. सो दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल आइडिया अबाउट हाउ मैक्रोज कैन बी क्रिएटेड एंड हाउ यू यूज देम इन ए वर्कशीट. And if you are using it in a worksheet, you need to save it also. And if you don't save it with a proper extension, there will be a problem. So I think this is more than enough for as far as macros are concerned for us. Otherwise, agar aap macros record karna chahte ho, to aap jab record macro karte ho, to jo bhi action aap screen ke upar karte ho, wo sare ke sare uspe record hokar ke aa jaate. I hope you are getting what I am.
Sir, you have uploaded this sheet to Google Classroom.
Yeah, I have.
First term, second term, third term is not coming. It is written hash name, which means your macros cannot be uploaded in the Google Classroom.
Actually, you will be able to see that only when you enable developer in your Excel sheet.
But it is in the Google Classroom.
It is in the Google Classroom. You download it and then open it in the Excel sheet and then enable this developer also. Actually, it asks you
in the beginning when you try to open it in the Excel.
Okay.
And it will work.
Okay.
But actually, the developer view is in file and then options.
Pardon, what are you saying?
Go to files. In the Excel sheet, I was talking about the macro tab, which you are initially searching for.
Ah, please, wo kahan tha?
File.
Files mein, options mein.
Achha, file mein, okay. File mein kahan jaise hai? बताओ
जैसे एक फाइल ओपन कीजिए सर पहले
ओके आई हैव टू ओपन ए न्यू फाइल ओके ऑल राइट लेट मी डू दैट कोई फाइल ओपन कर लो
हाँ सर कोई बात नहीं वही
ओके लेट मी ओपन दिस इटसेल्फ खोल लिया
फाइल क्लिक ऑन द फाइल
जस्ट फॉर अ मिनट Sorry. I have to go to
file.
मैं file पे जा रहा हूँ ना तो मेरे को तो यहीं पे ले आ रहा है ये.
यहाँ options.
Options.
2010 version है उसमें तो आ रहा है options.
इसमें नहीं है कोई नहीं मैं आपको कल बता दूंगा don't worry about it.
Last one is
option. Bottom पे है bottom पे बिल्कुल.
जो कुछ आपको चाहिए एनेबल कर सकते हो आप यहाँ पे
लेफ्ट साइड में कस्टम रिबन है सर नीचे से फोर्थ
ये कस्टमाइज रिबन ना
यस सर कस्टमाइज रिबन
ये आ गया हियर इट इज सो हियर देखिए यहाँ पे डेवलपर कहीं मुझे नजर आना चाहिए प्रोसीजर सो दैट एवरीबडी एल्स फॉलोज हियर आई गो टू फाइल आई गो टू ऑप्शंस व्हेन आई गो टू ऑप्शंस आई हैव टू गो टू customize ribbon and when I go to customize ribbon I get all those things which I want to see on that toolbar itself main bade dinon ke baad jab karta hu main bhul bhi jata hu kya I hope you understand what I am trying to tell you
yes
okay so I am just canceling it so ek exercise define kar dunga aapko classroom mein isme aap kya karna पहले अपनी स्क्रीन मुझे दिखाना जिसमें डेवलपर है नहीं फिर ऑप्शन में जाना और वो स्क्रीन रिकॉर्ड कर लेना एक्चुअली यू कैन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट स्नैप टूल यू कैन डू दैट एंड देन गो टू दिस फाइल गो टू ऑप्शन कस्टमाइज रिबन एंड देन क्लिक द डेवलपर वंस यू आर देयर देन यू विल फाइंड दैट ऑल दैट एनवायरमेंट विल बी अवेलेबल टू यू बाय द वे दिस डेवलपर इज नथिंग बट व्हाट It is a kind of a visual basic application editor. So when you want to really write down some kind of a visual basic code, you can write down that here. So हम लोग इसके बारे में mind में clear रखें कि हम कैसे क्या चीजें करना चाहते हैं. So tomorrow maybe I will take another 5-7 minutes and explain you a few things from there also. Is it fine? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we got it, and that's good. So you can see that how already there is a spreadsheet with you, in which there is a macro available. Rather, there are three macros available. I'm calling those as macros only, but I defined those as user defined functions, not as a macro. That video actually shows you how to record a macro without going into that developer environment as such, particularly in the editing part. तो आपने वहीं बैठ करके उसको कर लिया बट यू रिक्वायर स्टिल द डेवलपर इफ इट इज नॉट देयर यू विल नॉट एबल टू रिकॉर्ड अ मैक्रो द नेक्स्ट फाइनल थिंग व्हिच वाज देयर वाज दैट यू वर सपोज्ड टू हैव एक्सटेंशन
which is not just dot XLS, but XLSM. You have to save it as a worksheet in which a macro is available. Is that clear? So maybe if time will permit me, then I will try to make a small presentation also, and I will post it also so that you can see the whole procedure. If there are any questions, you are most welcome to ask. Either Sapna can respond or I can respond.
I think everything is clear, and today's chat box is very, very interactive. I suggest to all the participants, please copy this chat box and paste it in another file to save it. So ma'am has replied very well to all the queries posted in the chat box. So I suggest to the participants, please copy and save it in some another file or Word file. I think Harpreet ma'am is not here. So I want to thank all the resource persons for a wonderful and very interactive talk and on this Excel. And ma'am has explained very well all the queries and all the questions, all the doubts about Excel. Thank you very much.
Just 1 minute, Sapna. Can you really record this chat and post it in the classroom itself so that these queries get addressed here?
Sure, sir, sure.
Okay, my session today, in which we saw that how we can use all these ideas in doing science. Mind it, we are not doing spreadsheets only. Our aim is, our goal is to do science. Okay. और ये ना कहीं एक डायरी भी लगा लो यार, जिसमें ना लिख लेना चाहिए कि ये कैसे कैसे करते हैं हम चीजें, क्योंकि आप नहीं इनको याद रखोगे तो कुछ दिन के बाद भूल जाती है,
भूल जाता है
कंडीशन, भूला हुआ था मैं,
भूल जाता
है, भूला हुआ हूँ,
भूल जाता है
ये ना, आप कहीं रख लो, कोशिश करेंगे कि इसकी छोटी जैसी एक कहीं प्रेजेंटेशन जैसी बन जाए, सो दैट यू डोंट हैव टू रियली वरी अबाउट ऑल दैट.
एक चीज मैं बोलना चाह रही हूँ कि सब मैं एक्सपर्ट नहीं हूँ स्प्रेडशीट में, आई एम ऑल्सो लर्निंग विद माई स्टूडेंट्स, तो हो सकता है बीच में कुछ हेल्प आप लोगों ने करी. सो आई एम थैंकफुल टू प्रोफेसर आलूवालिया एंड शर्मिष्ठा मैम फॉर हेल्पिंग मी. आई मीन सम ऑफ फीचर्स मे बी आई डोंट नो एक्चुअली, क्योंकि आई हैवंट एक्सप्लोर्ड ऑल द फीचर्स ऑफ स्प्रेडशीट.
None of us know everything. None of us know. It's impossible to learn
everything. There was one very good question which was put by one of the participants.
Yes, that, yes.
पाई की वैल्यू मैं तो वो तो हो जाएगा, मैम ने दिखा भी दिया. देन शी आस्क्ड कि ग्रेविटेशनल कांस्टेंट लिख लूंगी मैं.
हाँ,
ग्रेविटेशनल कांस्टेंट की वैल्यू
इन बिल्ट, मैं आंसर डेट कि इन बिल्ट तो नहीं है, बट वी कैन ऑलवेज राइट ऑल द कांस्टेंट्स की वैल्यू खुद.
एक छोटा जैसा मैं एक्सरसाइज सजेस्ट कर सकता हूँ. पृथ्वी, आर यू लिसनिंग?
यस सर.
आप ऐसा करना, एक छोटी जैसी मैक्रो बनाना जिस मैक्रो में ना ग्रेविटेशनल कांस्टेंट की वैल्यू पड़ी हो, तो जब भी कैपिटल जी की वैल्यू की जरूरत पड़े तो मैक्रो से
उसको यूज कर लें.
दैट इज वन वे ऑफ डूइंग इट.
यस
सर. ये जो जो अगर स्मॉल जी लिखेंगे तो भी वो उसको उठा लेगा, और ओनली ये कैपिटल लिखेंगे तभी उठाएगा.
किस चीज को? ऑल कैपिटल
वो मैक्रो जो हम मैक्रो डिफाइन करेंगे. अगर हम उसको अपर केस में
ले लेता है, वो स्मॉल वगैरह में ले लेता है, जब उसको आप नाम दे देते हो तो ले लेता है वो.
मतलब वो केस सेंसिटिव नहीं है स्प्रेडशीट में, केस सेंसिटिविटी नहीं है.
सो दैट मींस इफ वी टाइप इन एक्सेल स्मॉल जी देन इट विल कॉल द कैपिटल जी वैल्यू आल्सो. दैट मींस नॉट केस सेंसिटिव मीनिंग इज दैट.
सो यू आर डिफाइनिंग द वैल्यू, यू विल राइट जी इज इक्वलेंट टू 9.81. So if you take small, write small g or capital G, because you have defined it like that, it will take 9.81. Suppose you want to make it specific, small g or capital G is 9.81, but the gravitational constant capital G, you write something else, maybe write G prime. And that value you give it as 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11. So when you write G prime, it will take the gravitational constant because it is not case sensitive.
यूनिवर्सल मैथमेटिकल वैल्यूज यूज करते हैं जिनकी वैल्यू हमको उसमें मिल सकती है, जैसे पाई है हर जगह इस्तेमाल होता है, एरिया निकालना है तब भी डाल रहे हो आप, कहीं और कुछ करना है तब भी आप उस पर ले रहे हो। फॉर एग्जाम्पल आयलर कॉन्स्टेंट ई, आप चेक करना इसकी वैल्यू हमें अवेलेबल है कहीं पे या नहीं है, मे बी इट इज अवेलेबल समवेयर, सो यू कैन ट्राई टू लुक एट दैट लिस्ट ऑफ यू नो बिल्ट इन फंक्शन इन विच पॉसिबली सच यूनिवर्सल कॉन्स्टेंट्स ऑफ द मैथमेटिक्स आर डिफाइंड इन द स्प्रेडशीट। I have not explored it. I am only making a suggestion. Please explore it.
No, it is inbuilt. EXP, open bracket, close bracket, it will give you the value of E.
Yes. It will be there.
But Planck's constant is not there.
I would like that somebody, one of the students should tomorrow come out and post it in the classroom itself. Sir, yes, our list is mein humne sare wo dhoond liye. So this is how we learn, you know, together. This is a learning process. We are trying to learn it together. Fortunately, देखिए हमारी सारी recording हो रही है, जो हमने ये option वाला parameter ढूंढना था, ये वाला parameter इसमें record हुआ हुआ है हमारी talk में, आप जाओ सुन लो एक बार फिर उसको repeat कर लो, यही ये beauty है recording की। अलग से ना भी हम करें, maybe somebody who knows editing can take this recording, उसमें से सिर्फ उतना पार्ट कट करके दिखा दो कि देखिए ऐसे जो है आप अपने टूल बार में वो डेवलपर वाला पार्ट ला करके डाल सकते हैं। तो आई होप दिस वाज अ वंडरफुल सेशन। ईशानी इज सेइंग देयर आर स्टैटिस्टिकल इंजीनियरिंग एंड मेनी मोर फंक्शंस। नो नॉट ईशानी, इन रिस्पांस टू ईशानी दी सपना रिस्पॉन्डेड टू दैट, सो दैट वाज वंडरफुल। What more is there? I think that is it.
Sir, for using macros, you have to have a knowledge of Visual Basic, all the syntax. Then only you can make it. Am I right?
Yes, you are right, ma'am. But in my case, you know, the advantage was this. You have seen our book on Basic, isn't it? So the syntax almost is same.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So those things which you have done there, we wrote that in 97, isn't it?
Yes, okay.
I say, I forgot the commands, but I can refresh those things very fast. Because I know what are looping things, I know what are the conditional statements which come. So, aur hota kya hai? Programming mein yehi to hota hai. There is nothing else. So, aapko for next pata hai, while wala pata hai, you can make use of those. You know the built-in functions of BASIC. So, same built-in functions come here also. You know the name subroutine, you know the name function there also. We were defining in BASIC also function and subroutine. So, you know, you must have observed, ma'am, I didn't go into the macro business.
No, but I'm surprised. So, since you have defined the macro as one first term, second term, third term, if I install developer into my Excel, how will you take one term, second term? Because it is your definition. You have
You are actually opening my file. And in my file, it has an extension M. And if it has that extension M, that means those modules are already there in that. So when you will see the list, you can see those things.
Yeah. Okay. Got it. Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
So, sir, Dr. Saab, I think we can stop here.
Okay, sir.
Thank you very much and good night.
Good night. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks. Thank you, ma'am.